month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary.
And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favour with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shalt call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David.
And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary his espoused wife, being great with child.
And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Thank you. Us More by Ruth Sawyer. Shall I tell you what will come to Bethlehem on Christmas morn?
Who will kneel them gently down before the Lord newborn?
One small fish from the river with scales of red, red gold.
One wild bee from the heather.
One grey lamb from the fold.
One ox from the high pasture.
One black bull from the herd.
One goatling from the far hills.
One white, white bird.
And many children.
God give them grace, bringing tall candles
to light Mary's face.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon Virgin Mother and Child, holy infant so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heaven.
Angel in the Cloakroom by Gervase Finn.
Last week, when I was looking for my PE kit in the cloakroom, I saw an angel. She was hovering above the coat hooks, smiling at me and waving a long, white hand. Her silver wings were trembling and her golden halo shimmered in the sun. This morning, she was there again, smiling and shimmering, flapping and fluttering, waving and trembling. She looked beautiful. I told my teacher, "Miss, there's an angel in the cloakroom." My teacher gave a little snort.
An angel?
She looked around the cloakroom, but the angel had gone.
Too much television,
she sighed.
Too lively imagination. A daydreamer, that's what you are. Angels indeed. Whatever next?
She smiled and shook her head, and then picked up a shining feather from the floor and put it in the bin.
Shepherds, oh, hark ye, glad tidings we bring. Peace and goodwill to the world now we sing. See in a manger,
Christ the anointed,
whom for your Saviour
God hath appointed.
Alleluia! In yonder manger, behold, now he lies, whom angel voices brought forth.
Bells by Judith Nichols.
One small chime, climb from the tower.
Follow me.
Follow.
And more chimes follow.
Shrill chimes.
Low chimes.
Dancing chimes.
Slow chimes.
Clanging chimes.
Ringing chimes.
Pealing chimes.
Singing chimes.
Chimes that trill.
Chimes that thrill.
Chimes that spill themselves over forests and rooftops.
Filling the earth and the skies.
Filling the sky and the earth.
With their Christmas message.
This is the day of Jesus' birth.
last-minute shoppers scurried about,
desperately seeking that one special gift that would give Christmas morning a magical lift.
As an old man stood standing,
listening to the song,
midst all the madness of the bustling throng. In a shaky, hoarse voice, he began to join in, singing the words of the famous old hymn.
One by one, people stopped with their madness to join with the old man for a moment of gladness.
By the time the carolers had finished with singing the song, the whole throng was united
as they all sang along.
As if by magic, from out of the sky, church bells rang out from a chapel nearby.
One by one, the people greeted each other with messages of goodwill they sent to one another.
You see, that magical lift the shoppers sought for so long
was not in the buying or scurrying along.
That magical gift
so desperately sought
was the spirit of Christmas,
which could never be bought.
Mm-hmm.